Hey everyone, it has been a while since I made the video, but today I wanted to show you how to make one of my favorite pastry doughs, which is the almond short crust. It has a great flavor, it is very easy to make, and it can be used for many different purposes. Personally, I use it to make decorations, cookies, rustic pies, or even contemporary cakes, like in this picture. So enough talking, let's get to the recipe.
So the ingredients for a dough are one delicious egg, butter cut in cubes, and it should be soft, so if you press it with your finger it should give away. Then we have some powdered sugar, wheat flour, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, almond flour, and some more flour.
To make the dough, start by mixing the smaller quantity of flour with the salt, the sugar, and the almond flour. Add the soft butter and the egg and mix everything together well with the rubber spatula. As always, you can find the exact recipe in the description box below this video. Once you have obtained a homogeneous mixture, add a large quantity of flour and bring the dough together. To do this, you may want to switch from using a rubber spatula to something that's more sturdy, like a dough scraper. Then cover your work surface with a piece of plastic wrap and deposit the dough on top of it. Using your hands, shape the dough into a square. Wrap the dough in a double layer of plastic foil and refrigerate it for at least 2 hours. This resting time will prevent the dough from shrinking back when we're rolling it out later. Take the dough out of the fridge and lightly flour your work surface. Roll the dough out to a thickness of 3 mm and cut it into the desired shapes. When you select the pastry cutter, always make sure that it is slightly larger than the mold you're trying to fit. To make the tart bottoms, transfer dough circles to a silicone mat. To make tart shells, spray a muffin tin with some baking spray or grease it slightly. Then take a dough circle and gently tease it into the muffin tin. Using some leftover dough, make a small ball and use it to press the dough against the edges of the muffin tin. This will improve the shape of your tart shells. Gently knead any leftovers and roll out again. To make decorations, roll the dough out to a thickness of 2 mm, which is the thickness of a euro coin. Use some small plastic cutters to make the decorations. Transfer the pieces of dough to a baking sheet. To make the tart shells, cover the dough with a small piece of baking paper and fill with dry rice or baking beans. Then cover the dough again and leave it to rest in the refrigerator for at least 30 minutes. This will prevent shrinkage of the dough during baking. Finally, bake the dough at 150 to 160 degrees Celsius until it's nicely browned. Baking at this low temperature will take a little bit longer, but it will allow us to get a nice browning on the whole dough instead of on just the edges. Therefore, we get that delicious nutty and roasted flavor. After about 15 minutes of baking, remove the baking paper and rice. Then bake for about 10 more minutes. Once the dough turns a beautiful brown and starts to smell like toasted nuts, take it out of the oven. For small decorations, this will take about 10 to 15 minutes. It will take about 15 to 20 minutes for larger pieces of dough. And for blind baking, it takes approximately 15 plus 10 minutes. Once the filling has been removed. Once the dough has cooled down, you can use it as you want. For example, glaze some half spheres of frozen chocolate mousse and transfer them to the almond short crust base. Decorate with some fresh strawberries and a small cookie. To make little tartlets, halfway fill the tart shells with some coffee ganache. Let it set in the fridge, then top with some salted caramel, and again use a small cookie as decoration. Now here's the money shot. Just have a look at these beautiful and delicious pastries. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions or requests for recipes, please leave a comment down below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you stay up to date with my new videos.